Manor View Elementary School principal Raquel Moore with an assist from students cutting the ribbon on renovations at the school. More from Manor View in a moment. Also this week, CYS fills backpacks, walk or bike to school the first day, and school safety. These stories and more, plus an advance look at the new Army Museum. Hello and welcome to the Back to School edition of Meade Week. I'm Brian Spann. As you saw in the opening, Manor View Elementary School hosted a ribbon cutting ceremony this week on a series of renovations.
Teachers, I know, are excited, students are enthusiastic, families are encouraging. It's a recipe for awesomeness. So welcome to the new Manor View. Thank you.
Anne Arundel County Public School Superintendent Dr. George Arlotta opening the ceremony. Other speakers included Maryland State Senator Pam Beidle, Anne Arundel County Executive Stuart Pittman, and Garrison Commander Colonel Eric Sprague, who detailed the extent of the renovations.
While the building itself can never replace the love, the passion, the instruction within its walls, it can facilitate a child's learning. Manor View Elementary is nearing the completion of a $35 million renovation project, which includes new HVAC, electrical and mechanical systems, expanded gymnasiums, modernized computer lab, enhanced natural and LED lighting, and a floor plan that provides a collaborative, quality educational experience our children deserve.
While not all of the construction is quite complete, like work on the interior courtyard, Manor View teachers, some who've moved their classrooms up to three times over the course of the construction, can finally settle in. Elsewhere, more than 250 Fort Meade kids are ready for school after last week's Fill the Pack event at School Age Centers 1 and 2 and the Teen Center. Fill the Pack is part of the Raytheon Company's partnership with the Boys and Girls Clubs of America and part of the company's $10 million pledge to support military families. In April, Fort Meade's Child and Youth Services opened a middle school teen STEM center, the result of a $45,000 grant from Raytheon and the Boys and Girls Clubs. This school year, Fill the Pack is providing 8,000 children and military families with backpacks, pencils, pens, highlighters, notebooks, pencil pouches, and water bottles. About 400 sets of school supplies were donated. CYS officials say that they'll continue to hand out supplies until they run out. Meanwhile, if you're catching the show before the first day of school, consider participating in Bike or Walk to School on the first day with your child. The Garrison-sponsored event is meant to highlight back-to-school safety. Parents are encouraged to join their kids on their way to school. Walk Bike to School is focused on community interaction and increased levels of safety. Law enforcement will be saturating school zones with personnel and vehicles. Service members and parents and partner organizations are invited to participate, but you should check with your chain of command. As we continue our back-to-school edition of Meade Week, you might want to pick up a copy of this week's Sound Off newspaper. Features a special back-to-school section with a Meade Schools directory, introductions to the new principals starting this year, and tips on school safety. Pick up your copy today. Finally this week, as you probably know, the Fort Meade Museum closed some time ago with most of its content sent to the new Army Museum at Fort Belvoir. The National Museum of the United States Army isn't scheduled to open until June 2020, but here's an advance look. That's Meade Week for this week. I'm Brian Spann. For everyone at Meade TV and the Fort Meade Public Affairs Office, have a great weekend and a great Meade Week.
So the visitor experiences some very unique aspects of the architecture of the facility itself. On the outside, you'll see the stainless steel. That represents the strength of the Army. You see the tower with the sixth floor with an illuminated lantern representing a beacon of safety and security. As you enter the lobby, you continue to march in with the soldiers through the pylons. We have illuminated, beautiful illuminated campaign streamers above. We have a colored Army emblem, 22 feet in diameter in the center of the lobby floor. And then as you take in the lobby and you learn about the campaigns and the battles associated with those that the Army has fought in.
Another unique component of the museum is the Experiential Learning Center. Here is where educators provide different types of G-STEM activities for children and adults of all ages to engage with. So you can learn how to build a bridge or look at the medical advancement that the Army has done over time. And it gives more education-focused way of teaching the history and heritage of the Army.
This is a place for soldiers, past and present, veterans, to bring their families, to bring their friends, to be able to showcase where they served and what they did, and be able to tell that story. As we open this museum, that we become such a touch point, such an asset for the Army to use in our relationship with American society.